Hello, and welcome to another episode. It appears that there is a good chance that the Andromedids meteor shower will have a strong outburst in the year 2023. A meteor shower originally came from the comet 3D Biela. This comet was first observed in the year 1772 and was the first comet to identify the link between comets and meteors. It was then observed to break up in 1845. And wasn't seen since. However, in 1872 and 1875, there were spectacular meteor outbursts observed. Historically, the Andromedids meteor shower started in 1741. However, after the comet breakup on the night of the 27th of November 1872, 10,000 meteors were recorded in one instance, and in England on that same night, 58,600 meteors was recorded. In fact, the Andromedids meteor shower has been kind of notorious for meteor storms. The more intense meteor showers were coming from the Cassiopeia constellation. However, as time went on and newer cometary streams were created by the comet, they seemed to move into the Andromeda constellation and became less intense, and hence the name Andromedids. Now the comet has broken up, the Andromedids usually only produce about 3 meteors per hour. However, in 2023, this is predicted to be in excess of 200. However, we don't know how likely this is going to be because we're not sure how much of the planetary fragment is left orbiting the Sun. But it is probably the last opportunity to see the Andromedids on such a scale. In fact, it should beat the average annual number of meteors for the Perseids and Geminids meteor showers. There was a Andromedids meteor shower outburst in 2011 that had 50 meteors per hour, so quite a lot more than the usual 3 meteors per hour. Interestingly, this occurred on the 5th of December, not the usual 9th of November, at about 9 p.m. to 12 p.m. Universal Time. What's important about this is roughly when we would expect the original Andromedids meteor shower to occur. Due to this, it appears that it's actually associated with an earlier Andromedids meteor shower, as the meteors are emanating from Cassiopeia and not Andromeda. In fact, in a simulation of the 2011 meteor shower, it appears that the meteor shower is actually due to the 1649 perihelion passage of the comet 3D Biela. A perihelion is when an astronomical object is closest to the Sun. There is also expected to be an outburst in 2036 of the Andromedids, but it's not expected to be as intense as a 2023 outburst. So the newer and weaker meteor showers should occur between around about the 9th to the 14th of November, and the older and more intense meteor showers should occur around the 4th to the 6th of December, around 9 p.m. to 12 p.m. Universal Time. This means that unlike many meteor showers, the Andromedids is actually good to view before midnight. And the moon won't actually be a problem in 2023. On the 9th of November, it will only be 22% illuminated, and on the 5th of December, when the main event should occur, it will be around about 50% illuminated. But because the meteor shower mainly occurs earlier in the evening, you'll get a chance to see it before the moon becomes too much of a problem. This is especially important as the meteors will be both small and slow, which means they won't be very bright. Because of this, you'll want to try and view them from a more remote location, so not somewhere that's got a lot of light pollution. So no city viewing if you can help it. In 2036, the moon is going to be 97% full on the 5th of December and about 77% on the 9th of November. So 2023 really is the best year to view this outburst if it does occur. Now, as this is quite a historical meteor shower, or hopefully big meteor outburst, I would like to do what we did for Tell Herculids and capture images of this meteor shower from around the world and then produce a collated video of the actual, probably the final big Andromedids meteor shower outburst for everyone to see. So to do this, I'm going to leave a link to a web form, both below this video and hopefully up here, so you can submit your photos and any video you've got as well. And then I'll be able to put it all together. Well, I hope you enjoyed that episode. And if you did, please do leave a like. If you have any comments, please leave them below. And if you'd like to see more astronomy videos, then please do subscribe.